discussion of the sole of foot. This is the left side of the lower limb, and here over the little toes it is the lateral border, and towards the great toe it is the medial border. First of all, we will discuss about the cutaneous distribution of the nerve innervation. The over the heel, the cutaneous distributions which is innervated by the directly the branch which is coming, the calcaneal branch which coming directly from the tibial nerve, which innervate to the over the skin, over the heel of the foot. Over the 3.5 medial toes, the skin cutaneous innervation, cutaneous distribution of the skin of the foot, which is innervated by the medial plantar nerve. And over the lateral 1.5 toes, which is innervated by the lateral plantar nerve. And the margin of the lateral margin into the middle part, which is innervated by the sural nerve. And the margin of the medial part up to the great toe, which is innervated by the saphenous nerve. Now we will discuss about the we already removed the skin, superficial fascia, and after that we can see this is a plantar aponeurosis. This plantar aponeurosis, it is the separated due to the evolution, it is separated part of the plantaris muscles. It is a separated part of the plantaris muscle. Here you can see this is the plantaris muscles. So it is a separated part of the plantaris muscles, plantaris which is inserted on the middle part of the posterior surface of the calcaneum with the tendo achillis. And this is a separate part which arises from the medial tubercle of the calcaneum. It is a plantar aponeurosis. It is a modification modification of the deep fascia as well as the plantaris, and it has a five slip. And this plantar aponeurosis, which divides the sole of foot into the three parts by the two vertical septum. One is the over the lateral side, it is a lateral vertical septum, and on over the medial, it is the medial septums. And it divides the foot into the three part: lateral part below to the septum, it is a central part, and medial to it is the medial part of the sole of the foot. Now we will remove the plantar aponeurosis. First layer of the sole of foot, it contains the three muscles: abductor, hallucis, first layer muscles. First layer of the sole of foot, it contains the abductor hallucis, flexor digitorum brevis, and abductor digiti minimi. Amongst the first layer, which is innervated by the abductor hallucis and flexor digitorum brevis, which is innervated by the medial plantar nerve, and the abductor digiti minimi, which is innervated by the lateral plantar nerve. The second layer of the muscles, which is formed by the two extrinsic muscles, this is the flexor digitorum longus, and another muscle, it is the flexor hallucis longus. And inside the tendon of the flexor digitorum longus, these are the intrinsic muscles of the second layer. It is the four lumbricals muscles, and the first lumbricals, which is innervated by the branches from the medial plantar nerve. So it is directly, you can see this is the medial plantar nerve which innervate to the first lumbricals, and second, third, and fourth lumbricals. And the second layer muscles, one is the quadrate plantar, or it is called the flexor digitorum accessorius, which is also innervated by the lateral plantar nerve. So flexor digitorum accessorius, second, third, and fourth lumbricals, which is innervated by the lateral plantar nerve. So second layer of the sole of the foot, which contains the two extrinsic muscles, flexor digitorum longus, which is posteriorly, which is connected by the flexor digitorum accessorius. And another muscles, extrinsic, it is the flexor hallucis longus. And the intrinsic muscles, inside the tendon of the flexor deodorum longus, there are four lumbricals. First, which is innervated by the medial plantar, and second, third, and fourth are innervated by the lateral plantar nerve, and flexor deodorum accessorius, which is directly which is innervated by the lateral plantar nerve. So the neurovascular bundles, which is lies between the first layer and second layer, here you can see this is a I can reflect the here you can see this one is the tibial nerve, and this tibial nerve, which divide into the two nerve, this is the medial plantar nerve, and this one is the lateral plantar nerve, and this is the lateral plantar artery, and this one is the medial plantar artery. Medial plantar artery and lateral plantar artery are the branch of the posterior tibial artery. This is the posterior tibial artery. So now the medial plantar artery, which is goes along with the between the tendon of the abductor hallucis and flexor deodorum brevis. Here you can see the it passes between the tendon of the abductor hallucis and flexor deodorum brevis. While the lateral plantar nerve and vessels, which is passes between the initially between the abductor digiti minimi and flexor deodorum brevis. And so the neurovascular bundles, superficial branch of the lateral plantar nerve and medial plantar nerve, which is lies between the first and second layers. So here you can see this is the lateral plantar nerve, and lateral plantar nerve at the base of the fifth metatarsals, it divide into the two branches. This is the superficial branch, and this superficial branch, which innervate the lateral one and half toes by the common digital and common digital, which is divide into the proper digital branches. So lateral one and half great toe, which lateral one and half toes, which is innervated by the lateral plantar nerve, while the medial plantar nerve the lateral plantar nerve, the deep branch, which is goes deeply, and along with the deep branch of the lateral plantar vessels, and it is goes inside the between the second and third layer, and the medial plantar nerve, which is divide into the common digital branches. This is the common digital branch of the medial plantar nerve. There are three common digital branch and one medial branch. Here you can see this is the one medial branch directly innervate to the medial side of the great toe, and three common digital branch, which again it divide into the proper digital branch, and it innervate to the medial three and a half toes, skin over the medial three and a half toes, which is innervated by the medial plantar nerve. So this is the second layer, and now we reflect the first and second layer. After that, we can see the third layer of the sole of foot. Third layer of the sole of foot on the lateral aspect, it is formed by the flexor digiti minimi brevis. This is the flexor digiti minimi brevis. Adductor hallucis, here you can see this is the adductor hallucis. It has a two head. This is the oblique, and this is the transverse head of the adductor hallucis. And just medial to the flexor hallucis longus, this is the flexor hallucis brevis. So third layer, it contains the flexor hallucis brevis. Adductor hallucis have a two head, oblique and transverse head, and flexor digiti minimi brevis. The flexor digiti minimi brevis and adductor hallucis, which is innervated by the lateral plantar nerve, and the flexor hallucis brevis, which is innervated by the medial plantar nerve. So it is the third layer of the sole of foot, and here you can see inside the third layer of the sole of foot, after reflecting this adductor hallucis, you can see here this is the deep branch of the lateral plantar nerve. Along with it, this is the you can see this is a lateral plantar artery, and this lateral plantar artery, which gives the deep branch, here you can see this is the deep branch, and this deep branch of the lateral plantar artery, which is goes medially, and space inside the first intermetatarsal space, it goes dorsally or upwards, and it is anastomosis with the, this is the anterior artery, and it between the two malleoli it is continues as a dorsalis pedis artery, and this dorsalis pedis artery between the first dorsal intermetatarsal space, which is goes deep inside, and it anastomosis with the, it continues as a deep plantar artery, and it anastomosis with the deep branch of the lateral plantar artery on the medial aspect, and it complete the plantar arterial arch. Here also you can see this artery, lateral plantar artery, it has a superficial branch, and it gives the perforating branch, and this perforating branch of the lateral plantar artery as well as the medial plantar artery, here you can see this is the branches coming from the stop karje. Here you can see this this is the medial plantar artery along with the medial plantar nerve, and towards the lateral side you can see this is a lateral plantar artery, and this is the arch, and it gives the perforating branches. Here you can see these perforating branches which perforate, and it is anastomosis with the perforating branch of the arcuate artery over the perforating branch of the arcuate artery of the, here we not seen, but I will show you the arcuate artery which gives the perforating branches into the second, third and fourth metatarsal space, and which makes the anastomosis. Perforating branches of the from the plantar surface, perforating branches of the lateral plantar artery, and it makes the plantar arterial arch by the perforating branches. And the last layer, it contains the, here you can see this is a plantar introcii, these are the three plantar introcii and four dorsal introcii. You can see here only we have dissected the first dorsal introcii, but remaining we have not dissected. Here you can see second dorsal introcii, but these are the total seven introcii muscles, three plantar introcii and four dorsal introcii, all are innervated by the deep branch of the lateral plantar nerve. So this is about to the inside the fourth layer also. You can see this is the obliquely the muscles which is closest from lateral to medial side, it is the peroneus longus, and from medial to lateral sides at that level it crosses the tibialis posterior, and this two muscles which makes the sling crosses inside opposite to the each other inside the fourth layer of the sole of the foot. So inside the fourth layer of the sole of foot, this peroneus longus and tibialis posterior, as well as these are the seven introcii, mainly three plantar introcii and four dorsal introcii, which all are the supplied by the deep branch of the lateral plantar nerves. So this is about to the layers of the sole of the foot.